his bloody shirt. That night they came back to their father in tears, saying, "Father, we went out to run a race and left Yusuf together with our things, and then a wolf appeared and ate him up. But you are never going to believe us now, not even though we really tell the truth." The miracle revealed by God to Prophet Yusuf was not long in coming. A caravan passing by the well found him. However, they had an ulterior motive for rescuing him. They wanted to sell him as a slave. The slavery system was widespread in Egypt in those years. Child slaves were particularly valuable. Some travelers came that way and then dispatched their water drawer, who left his bucket down. He said, "Good news for me, I've found boy." They then hid him away among their goods. God knew very well what they were doing. They indeed achieved their aim, and sold him very cheaply to an Egyptian. The Egyptian who had bought him told his wife, "Look after him with honor and respect. It's possible he will be of use to us, or perhaps we might adopt him as a son." And thus we established Yusuf in the land to teach him the true meaning of events. God is in control of his affair. However, most of humanity do not know. The family who purchased Prophet Yusuf placed him under their protection. They raised him with affection and compassion. They even considered adopting him. God was at all times by Prophet Yusuf's side. And these were all blessings given him by God. And new tests awaited him. When Prophet Yusuf reached maturity, his beauty began to attract the attention of a great many women. First among these was the lady of the house in which he lived, in other words, the wife of the Egyptian governor. Before long, the governor's wife made an improper suggestion to him. Prophet Yusuf rejected the woman, however, knowing that this would be a violation of God's laws. He immediately sought refuge in him. The behavior of Prophet Yusuf in the face of this incident is described in the Quran as thus. The woman whose house it was wanted to seduce him, she barred the doors and said, "Come over here." He said, "God is my refuge. He is my Lord and has been good to me with where I live. Those who do wrong will surely not succeed." She wanted him, and he would have wanted her, had he not seen the clear proof of his Lord. That happened so we might avert from him all evil and indecency. He was our chosen servant. But the governor's wife was very angry with him. And although he was innocent of any crime, she uttered a great slander against him. She told her husband that Prophet Yusuf had approached her with improper intentions. She demanded that he be punished. They raced to the door. She tore his shirt at the back. They met her husband by the door. She said, "How should a man whose intention was to harm your family be punished for what he did except with prison or painful punishment?" What happened is revealed in the Quran. He, Yusuf, said, "It was she who tried to seduce me." A witness from her people then declared, "If his shirt is torn in front, she speaks the truth, and he has clearly told a shameless lie. If his shirt is torn at the back, then she has lied, and he has clearly told a simple truth." This was in fact an indication of Prophet Yusuf's innocence. The woman had torn Prophet Yusuf's shirt from behind. The significance of that was clear. She had come up behind him as he moved towards the door. At this, the governor realized that Prophet Yusuf was innocent and accepted that his wife was the one responsible. He saw the shirt torn at the back and said, "The source of this is women's deviousness. Without a doubt, your guile is very great. Yusuf, ignore all this, and you, my wife, should ask forgiveness for your evil act. There is no doubt that you are in the wrong." However, the matter was not yet over. People began talking about what had happened between Prophet Yusuf and the governor's wife. It was clear that the governor's wife was the guilty party. Many people therefore criticized her. Some city women said, "The governor's wife solicited her slave. He's fired her heart with love. We see that she's the one to blame." The governor's wife was greatly upset by all this talk against her. She therefore began preparing a plan. Her aim was to prove that she was right in her improper suggestion to Prophet Yusuf. Because Prophet Yusuf was an extraordinarily handsome person, and many women were amazed at his beauty. But when she heard of their malicious talk, she sent for them and made a sumptuous meal. And then she gave a knife to each of them. She said to Yusuf, "Go out to them." When they saw him, they were amazed by him and cut their hands. They said, "God preserve us. This is no man. What can this be but a noble angel here?"